take the stage with one of my very, very good friends in the cannabis space. His name is Brian McLaren. He is the CEO of Zoned Properties, just gone up. Zoned Properties is a publicly traded company, in case you're wondering, ZDPY or ZDPY on the OTC markets.
For our Canadian friends.
Yes, sir. How are you doing today?
Doing great. Hello, everyone.
Tell us a little bit. You know, I was thinking, you know, it would be a good segue. The Latino Cannabis Association will be setting up like 24 licenses, and they will all be needing real estate. And that is certainly your wheelhouse.
Yeah.
I don't know. Instead of, you know, who you are and what you do, just like.
Yeah, let's get right to it. One of the coolest parts. And we'll talk about what Zoned Properties is, what we do. We've been around for almost a decade in the space. But what's great about that panel a few ago, the LCA, is they're talking about upcoming cannabis market in New York, very focused on diverse operations, social equity. And I think they said 14 of the 25 members are going to go for retail. You get that Trinity, those three retail sites under a license. So immediately, that's 42 retail sites that are all going to need real estate. And they discussed the value of having those existing business owners and operators that understand regulations, the New York marketplace. But one of the most challenging pieces that a lot of groups don't factor in early enough is the real estate. Not just the capital, so raising debt or working on sale leaseback transactions, acquiring your own site. But you got to find these sites in the first place to be able to apply for your license. Once you get the license, you got to make sure you develop those in a regulated manner. So, I mean, immediately a really cool connection here at the conference that those are users in real time that need the types of real estate services we're going to talk about right now.
You know, one of the services that are, you know, kind of the solutions that you're thinking about and you're offering is, you know, PropTech. Property technology, right? And it's a very good way of democratizing real estate and access to real estate, right, through technology. You have a very cool partnership with Zonomics. Can you tell us a little bit about?
Yeah. So maybe just to set the landscape here for anyone that's unfamiliar with us. So Zoned Properties, we're based out of Scottsdale, Arizona. We've been around at this doing real estate development for regulated cannabis sites across the country now for almost 10 years. So our bread and butter is everything that happens before and after the capital raising when it comes to cannabis and real estate. So if you find that right partner that's going to give you $2, $10, $30, $50 million plus, you better make sure you're developing, permitting that site in a way that's not going to jeopardize that money. So that's everything we do in commercial real estate is on that other fork in the road. The capital, the REITs, the sale leasebacks, super important. The other fork in the road is Zoned Properties, real estate development services and firms. So a little bit of data. You know, I love data. I'm kind of an urban planning nerd by trade, which is how I got into the industry. I was a little too obsessed playing SimCity growing up. So thinking about where these real estate sites go, specifically retail, you want to get direct to consumer with your dispensary, you got to make sure you have a great site. Easier said than done. So in that process, across this country, as state by state legalization happens, hopefully we're going to see some federal movement sooner than later, but you have about 40,000 localities in this country that are governing and setting up codes that dictate where these sites can go in the community. All of these individuals are like us. They're members of the community in the planning department. They're figuring this out real time, very complicated. A few other interesting statistics before we dive into the property technology.
Please do.
I was just looking this morning, and it looks like there's about 7,600 dispensaries in this country right now that are licensed. Of course, half of those are in Oklahoma and Oregon. But if you compare that to other major retail and similar parallel marketplaces, for example, there's about 15,000 Starbucks in this country, 44,000 liquor stores, essentially wine, beer, and spirits, selling liquor to consumers. So if we want to use those as some benchmarks of where cannabis retail sites will be growing in the coming years, that's probably a good benchmark. Somewhere between 15 and 40,000 dispensaries could easily be in this country as the licensing shifts state by state. that's almost on average one per locality. All of that is extremely difficult to work with the local community to overcome the 100 years of propaganda convincing that this is actually going to be good for property values, job creation in the community, economic development, tax dollars, helps decrease opioid and drug abuse in other markets, and we can go on and on, right? So the problem we had as a company is that we've spent the better part of the past decade figuring out how to navigate that process for ourselves and clients. Originally, we raised about $12 million to deploy into real estate acquisition development. We own a bunch of those properties today. We have an investment portfolio. But along that pathway, we couldn't find anyone to help us. No standard commercial real estate brokerages would work in the space. Talk about going through escrow and title policy for transfer of property. You walk into a city council meeting to try and convince them to give you a permit, right? Like, these are all extremely challenging things that operators in the space face. And for those of you that are investors, you better make sure your investment target and operator understands these things. So over the years, we had to develop our own commercial brokerage team. We had to develop our own consulting and advisory services. And that's a huge part of our business today nationally. We work with multi-state operators, social equity applicants, mom and pops, to help them develop their real estate. But we're a boutique commercial brokerage firm.
More or less.
Yeah, I mean, we like to think we're...
You're humble.
We like to think we're big and national and can talk big game, but the reality is we've got 5 people directly in our office in Scottsdale. We've got a team of about 30 in partnerships across the country, but that's not going to cut it for up to 40,000 dispensaries alone, not including cultivation, processing, lab testing facilities. We got to scale this. And so for the past several years, and I told Javier I was going to exclusively announce this news during the fireside chat.
Pay attention. This is exclusive news breaking right now for a publicly traded company.
Right.
ZDPY about to drop news, like we say in Latin America, para oreja, atentos, pay attention.
That's right.
Exclusive.
So for many years, we've been developing a property technology platform. We realized the only way to service this entire national market at scale to actually help and make an impact that's needed to do this right was through technology. We searched and used many other platforms. We never wanted to build our own. But we started looking into partnerships with GIS mapping software companies, data platforms, and other property technology platforms that could deliver but haven't worked in cannabis yet. Several years ago, we met a company called Zonomics out of New York. Their mission is democratizing real estate data and information, period. And I approached the CEO, Matthew Player, and said, hey, could you do this for cannabis? And so as of today, about 30 minutes ago, we formally launched the public beta for Rezone, rezone.io. Go check it out. You can send in a demo or beta access request form. The goal of the platform is to assist all operators, large and small, with finding these green zone parcels. You got to be 1,000 feet from a church, 500 feet from a bus stop. I mean, if you've been in this industry, you know that local planning departments, and they're some of the heroes out there. Be patient. A lot of them are trying to do it the right way, but they make a lot of mistakes, and that complicates it. So our goal for Rezone, this property technology platform, is to put all of this information so you don't have to have 40 screens on your laptop, whether you're a direct company looking for real estate, property owner looking to lease, permit and lease your real estate, property investor. There's 120,000 commercial brokerage firms in this country. As they start to wake up to this $200 billion industry of economic impact, they're going to be looking for tools and resources to help operators and vice versa. So that's what Rezone's all about, getting that information in a single uniform platform to help deliver this information really to the industry so we can all move forward.
So that's Rezone.io, right?
Correct. Yep.
Look at me winning the spelling bee.
That's right. Awesome.
And but you know, you know, what else do we know about this? Like how it works, you know, don't get too nerdy again, but like how it works, why it matters, who is it? You kind of went into the users, but like, can you elaborate a little bit on this platform since it's the first time we're hearing about it?
Yeah, and again, the goal is have a lot of stuff hidden behind the scenes so that user experience is as easy and simplistic as possible, but there's a lot working. So the platform is based on artificial intelligence, some of which is patent pending through our partner at Zonomics, and machine learning software to help you move forward. So essentially what you're going to do is you're going to get on this platform, and again, we're launching the public beta, so bear with us. This is a very complicated process. Anyone that's been through it understands, you're combining constantly changing local codes with county mapping and GIS data and software to try and give you a single map at the click of a couple buttons that'll show you a green highlighted square somewhere where you want to put your cannabis facility. That's essentially the short version. But from what I've seen over the years, the reason platforms have failed when they've tried this is they've tried to do a yes or no, thumbs up, thumbs down. This industry is too volatile and complicated this early on. So how we like to approach it is a pause, proceed. It's a 80% efficiency tool to help you move forward. And then ideally what we want to do if we're democratizing this process is that the platform then connects users with other pieces of the puzzle. So it's going to bring you to other property technology platforms. We have some other property technology partners at this event we're talking to about how to integrate these things. Everything not just from finding a zoned property, getting its permit and a site identified and locked up, but then you got to go through the whole development process. You better have a really good construction development team at your disposal to get that done right and efficiently. You better be able to track that process. So in a nutshell, it's an efficiency tool for users. And for us as a company, it's an efficiency tool. So for about 6 months, we have been using this internally for our own clients, getting through the initial bugs and kinks. Those have led to some pretty big license lottery winners in multiple states across the country. And so we see this as a way to really scale zoned properties beyond our boutique commercial real estate firm. But for us, it's also a catalyst. What I love about property technology is that you can kind of have your cake and eat it too. So you can spread that data and information to a really wide audience, and you can make a lot of cash flow and revenue from that process at a fair price. So it's something that we view as fueling our company. It's property technology with advisory and brokerage that eventually fuels our pipeline of real estate investments and acquisition targets.
And it could be, right, like a pretty big catalyst for the zone property stock too, right? It's been a long time thesis of mine that especially for ancillary cannabis businesses, creating a product that starts in the cannabis space but can be replicated in other industries is key to long-term success. Do you envision this platform going beyond cannabis?
Yeah, great question. I think we're living it real time. So what I can say is that after, again, almost a decade of being an advisory brokerage and real estate development team and company, the property technology side of commercial real estate is the first thing I've seen that I believe can transform us as a company to scale nationally. And it's not just this initial rezone platform that addresses a pretty niche market value proposition. I mean, 40,000 localities are going to need to build these green zone maps. Lots of localities are doing it by hand on Google Earth, the way many of us have probably done it for anyone who's done it. So it starts with that mapping platform for cannabis, and then it translates to other regulated markets. Then it translates to much larger. I mean, if you think about it, all commercial real estate is regulated. All commercial real estate is governed by these 40,000 localities or so. It's actually 95,000, but about half are school districts and other utility districts. So that's a really large scalable platform that we believe our core mission of providing a full spectrum of real estate services to emerging and highly regulated markets. It's the first tool I think we've really seen that is going to let us not just accomplish that mission, but at scale.
Let me double down on that, though. You know, you say all commercial real estate is regulated. Then why the hell are we still doing this by hand? Like, why didn't someone think of this before, right? It doesn't seem as complex as it evidently is.
Yeah, I think it's the same thing I joked about earlier. It's like my whole history, you know, for the decade before I was doing cannabis real estate, I was in urban planning, community development, sustainable development. Sometimes it's not the sexiest topic. So when you think about, you know, commercial real estate data, one thing I found this past year I was joking with Javier and Elliot about is like, I go on all these cannabis podcasts and start talking about community planning and real estate, and you can start to hear the crickets sometimes a little bit. You know, it's such an important piece, but it's so challenging. There's so many numbers. What's the loan to value? What percent of capital can I get? When do I deploy it, right? So I think we found the same thing with zoning, permitting, and urban planning in general. You know, if you go on a commercial real estate podcast and you start talking about cannabis zoning, it's like the most interesting topic they've covered all year, right? It's kind of the inverse. So for me, Javier, it's kind of the same with this property technology. You know, it's not CoStar, right? There's a reason CoStar is a behemoth. And any one of those 120,000 commercial brokerages use that data platform for their brokerage work. But the zoning side of things, it's not as sexy. You know, it's not here's how you go down a transaction in a brokerage firm and get to that deal close, but it's the necessary element in all of those localities, in all of the projects. And real estate can be, you know, we're trying to reshape the landscape a little bit. Real estate can be a very wealthy person's game. It's very difficult. I mean, even for us as a company, our history, we were one of the very first public companies to have the word cannabis or marijuana in our 10K and our Qs. I think we're on year 7 of full public audit and SEC reporting. I mean, we've been around for a while. And I think where we've struggled is that, again, we're on that other fork in the path. We're not a REIT. You know, we didn't go raise $1 billion to deploy through sale leaseback transactions, but we've been quietly building. Oh, awesome. They put the slide up. We've been quietly building this. So as I was saying earlier, essentially like the center of this four-part vertical, advisory and brokerage, that's our active revenue. We see that as really growing our boutique firm. We have partnerships across the country. We just teamed up with a huge commercial brokerage out of New York called Ripco, landing million square foot greenhouse brokerage listings that we're going to be bringing to market together nationally. So that's where we go with the active part of our company. But once it's not active, your revenue turns off, right? You got to keep going direct personnel hours. That's where we love the property technology side. So we don't have to build a team of 500 people to go to these 40,000 localities. If we can get the property technology platform done right, which we're confident we can, we see the scale coming to the company. And again, for us, zoned property is really our value proposition, not just that catalyst and that active revenue, but building a smart, right now we have a debt-free portfolio of properties that are fully leased to cannabis companies in Arizona with some significant expansion, but it all has to go together. We see that full spectrum of real estate services because we went through it ourselves. You know, we've been there. We know if you have one piece and not the others, you're going to have challenges. So for us, that's what it's all about.
Before we stepped on stage, Brian told me, feel free to get sassy with questions. And, you know, you were just saying, I'm thinking right now, like, you were saying, when I talk to cannabis people about zoning, I get crickets. And then REITs are raising billions, right? Like, not that you didn't say the two consecutively, but you know, those are two takeaways. Why didn't you go the REIT route instead of the cricket route?
Yeah, I think honestly, we were just a little too early. One of the original intentions, and there's a couple of people in the audience here that have been with me since the beginning, early investors in the company, thank you, early partners. It's timing, right? That's this whole cannabis conversation is all about timing. If you were listening to the MSO panel earlier this morning in the ballroom stage, you know, we're maybe in the first couple pitches of the first inning when you really think about this, when you think about the scale, the regulations. I mean, we're still having conversations about how to get access to banking and reasonable tax reform. So no taxation without representation, right? I mean, I think for us in our evolution as a company, we just came too early to be a REIT. In 2014, 15, 16, the conversations I was having with our advisors on the Hill, with our IRS experts, is really there was no way to go do what the big REITs have done today. So we went the other fork in the road because we were, again, in the process ourselves. We deployed capital. We were developing these sites. We had to figure it out, and we figured it out. So then we looked at how do we provide and scale this service for the thousands and thousands, what are we, 500,000 professionals in cannabis now? I mean, our industry is not just emerging, it's going to be exploding. So I think, you know, why did we go that route? A necessity, a need for ourselves, but we heard it from everyone else. So from clients of ours that tend to be split between cannabis operators that need real estate solutions, we kind of fancy ourselves a bolt-on brain trust for a lot of the groups, but also just property owners that have questions trying to figure out how do we navigate this? How do we make sure that we actually get the permits? So when I put $20 million into development at a grow site, you know, my attorney doesn't call me and say, hey, by the way, the planning board just called, your permit was never correctly filed, and we have a challenge. You know, that happens all the time. So for me, that's the fascinating side. And what we've been quietly building as a public company is really that four-part cross-pollinating service route that now we see a serious avenue to scale. That's what property technology will allow us to do. You know, we're definitely going to continue to deploy our cash flow. We've had positive cash flow for many quarters. We're having good growth as a company. Property technology will let us scale nationally. In a great position to raise, I think, some healthy debt now, seeing finally some reasonable debt if you've had some operating properties with good cash flow. Will we eventually maybe consider going the REIT route or separating the company into services and a REIT if it's in the best interest of shareholders?
Fantastic. I wanted to take some questions from the audience, but we've run out of time. It's just been a fantastic conversation. Everyone, before that, wait. How can people reach you? I mean, I'm sure many of them have questions both here and watching from home. Yeah. So how can people reach you? Of course, here at the Benzinga Cannabis Capital Conference, but
Great question. So definitely on the property technology side, if you interact with that space at all, check out our today launched exclusive notice through Benzinga here, rezone.io. Click that button to get a demo and request beta access. Our team will get back to you immediately and start working that access. And for everything else, zonedproperties.com. We're active on Twitter at Zoned Properties. I'm constantly tweeting local hearings and council meetings. If you see the city you're working in, pay attention and click on that. Or you can always email me directly, Brian, B-R-Y-A-N, at zonedproperties.com. Get at us. We talk to people all the time, formally, informally. We're really just trying to help this entire industry move that planning and zoning in the right direction.
Let's hear it for Brian McLaren from Zoned Properties, ZDPY on the OTC. Thank you, Brian.